This is how delta H, delta S, delta G, and K are all related. We're asked to calculate delta H, delta S, and delta G at 298 K for the reaction shown. As you know, to get delta H of reaction, we should take the heat of formation of the products, that would be POCl3, minus the heat of formation of the reactants, that would be PCl3, minus 1/2, we're going to use the coefficients as well, O2, and by simply putting that in our calculator, we ought to be able to figure that out. So we have minus 542.2 minus a minus 288.07 minus 1/2 times 0. Plugging that into our calculator, the value is minus 254.13 kilojoules per mole of reaction as written. We can do the same thing with delta S, except we're going to take the S's of formation. So for POCl3, it is 325 minus PCl3, that is 311.7 minus 1/2 the oxygen entropy, which is 205.03. Plugging that into our calculator gives us a value of minus 89.215, and that's going to be in joules per Kelvin mole. Now, if we had the values for the free energies of formation, we could use the same formula, or we could use the free energy formula, which tells us that delta G at some temperature is equal to delta H minus T delta S. So we could just substitute our values from above. We have a minus 254.13 kilojoules per mole for our delta H. Our temperature is 298. And our delta S, since the first value is in kilojoules, I should put my delta S in kilojoules. That would be a minus 0.089215 kilojoules per Kelvin mole, which I get by dividing this answer by 1,000. Plugging that into my calculator, I get minus 227.54 kilojoules per mole. Now, since the delta G value is negative, this tells us that the reaction is extensive, meaning it goes forward and makes a lot of product at 298 Kelvin. Okay, the next part of this question asks us to figure out the equilibrium constant and then calculate its value. First, we'll write the expression. K is equal to products raised to their coefficient over reactants raised to their coefficient. And an important thing here, we only use either aqueous state or gaseous state. So for our particular materials, everything is in the gaseous state, and we can also represent those as pressures. So I will take the pressure of POCl3 on top. That is my product. I will also have the pressure of PCl3 on the bottom. Both of these are to the first power, but the pressure of O2 will be to the 1/2 power, since a 1/2 coefficient is in front of the oxygen. The next question is, figure out the actual numeric value of K. And K, you may remember, is also equal to E to the minus delta G divided by RT. So, substituting in our values, that will be a e to the minus, and where did our value go? There it is, minus 227.54 divided by r. Now, since we're in kilojoules for our delta G, r should probably be also the kilojoule value, so that would be 0.008314 kilojoules per Kelvin mole, and also times the temperature of interest, which is 298 Kelvin. So we will have to multiply this out and put E to that particular power. So that means we are actually equal to E to the 91.84. That is a tremendous value. Let's hope our calculator can process it. And that turns out to be 7.70 times 10 to the 39th. Well, that is a very big K value. That means make a lot of product. Our last question asks us, can we estimate the value of K at a different temperature, say 450 degrees Kelvin? Certainly. First, we'll have to find out delta G, though, at that temperature. So delta G at 450 is going to be equal to delta H minus T delta S. I will take my delta H from above, that's minus 254.13 kilojoules per mole, and I will subtract 450 times my value of delta S, which is minus 0.089215 kilojoules per Kelvin mole. And my delta G at 450 turns out to be a minus 213.98 kilojoules per mole. So you notice that's a little bit smaller value than before, less negative anyway, for delta G. So our reaction is getting less extensive, but still product is preferred. And now we can say that K will be equal to E to the minus, a minus 213.98 kilojoules per mole, divided by 0.008314 kilojoules per Kelvin mole, times the temperature of interest, which is 450 degrees Kelvin. This will have us bring E to the 57.19, which, when we put that into our calculator, is equal to 6.909 times 10 to the 24th. Still a very good reaction. Now, one last thing about sig figs. Going back and looking at our work for delta H reaction, it looks like my most accurate or least accurate value is to the tenths place, so technically I should report delta H to the tenths place. Looking at my delta S value, that appears to have the least accurate value at the integer, so that belongs there. Now, when I multiply this out, I am subtracting a slightly smaller number, but it is only good to the integer level, I believe. So technically, my delta G is only also good to the integer level for here, and also for here, so I should round that up to minus 214, and this up to minus 228. And finally, my K value. I am taking this to a particular value, which is an exponent and that. So technically my K is incredibly accurate. I should actually have an additional place here on this one, and this one is fine as is. All right, that was a very long problem.